High school was great.
Amazing.
I threw a major party. I just started throwing parties and we started making a lot of money. Now, I'm going to fast forward because you may have questions for this. And I have a friend of mine, Howard, who's pretty much just filming now, but he's seen me from the beginning. And what I'm about to tell you all, he didn't know about as well. At a certain point, there's this thing. Do you know about the 10,000 hours? Are y'all familiar with this philosophy? No. Okay, 10,000 hours. For you to master a craft, you have to have at minimum 10,000 hours on. If you spend 10,000 hours on one particular thing, I'm a motivational speaker, so if I spend 10,000 hours on something, I will become the master of that. A master of that. So imagine just putting 5,000, maybe 6,000 hours. People don't realize that Bill Gates, before he became Bill Gates, his mother invested in a computer, or the community had got this particular, like it was like a computer lab or whatnot within the community, and they spent their time when they were young on the computer. No one really talks about that. What you invest in, what you study when you're young, probably some of the things that you may be great at, where you want as an entrepreneur, is something that you, what you'll probably become more wealthy in, and everything, financially and IQ, all that, is something that you've probably been doing for years, that you probably do for free. Me as a speaker, I get paid to speak, but I've always loved doing this, to give people insight, to development. But now, as an entrepreneur, I realize that I can also put it into the market for value. Value in terms of as a price. So the more that you invest in something, the more value you become. Same thing with your problems. If you're able to solve problems within your life or within your business, the more value you become to the company, the more the company becomes of value as well. Now, this is so funny because me and my accountant always talks about this. You figure from the time that I started my business, and I used to keep account in my journal, it's like a little, a little composition book. And until the time I got to maybe probably close to 2021, I probably seen at minimum $150,000. At minimum. And I would spend money crazy. Now here's the part where it becomes a problem for me. I didn't have any advisors. I didn't have anybody in my circle that wasn't just, I had yes men around me. People see me, they were just doing so many amazing things. Oh my gosh, Rahfeal, you're just making so much money. Oh my gosh, Rahfeal's the man. I would be the angel investor when I was in college. I was helping people, they didn't have money, financial aid, they didn't give you enough money, I would pay for your books, I'll pay for your class. Oh, you love her, you want to get married, I'll take care of the wedding. I'll pay for you to go down and get your license or whatever it may be. Oh, you need to, I got you. Let me tell you something, entrepreneurship is a beautiful thing, but it also can be, a burden sometimes, especially when you got money coming in, you know what to do with it? Y'all have no idea. Freshman year, I bought a limo. It's now you're a freshman, you're 18, 19. I bought a limo on the campus because I wanted the people to know, like, I'm Rahfeal. I am the youngest businessman from Northern New Jersey. So I'm in a freshman dorm, and I come out because it's a Greek party. And of course, freshmen, we walk in, if you remember your freshman year, it's like, you're kind of like at the bottom again, you start all over again, like it's like 13th grade, as I always called it. And I walk out the dorm, and I have a long stretch, like white navy. And I remember I had all my friends, some majority of my friends didn't even go up to college, but they were on the campus because they wanted to jump in this limo and go to the club with me too. And I was like, yeah, we're going to the club. And I remember literally everyone looked at me like, who is this kid? But one of the things was, okay, it was a bad move because why would I waste, why would I want to buy a limo? But the second thing was, what's interesting was the branding piece. So that means that I'm now the man on the campus. I am now the dopest, hottest, swagged out, no one can touch my swag, I'm hot. Freshman on Montclair State University's campus. And ever since then, it was just weird to me because I started, of course, celebrities would come through SGA, wouldn't give organizations enough money for certain things, so I was giving the money. But I always told those who I gave money to, don't worry, you don't have to tell anybody who I am because I know everyone's going to keep asking. But I didn't know what to do with it. When you're young, you don't have any responsibility. I got a cell phone bill. I don't pay rent. I live on the campus. The state paid for me to go to school, so because I was homeless. So because of the state paying me, they gave me money just so I can buy clothes or whatever. So I had that, and I would just take that money and invest it. I was buying stocks. I did all that stuff. But at a certain point, I realized, this can't be. At a certain point, I started losing it. All the parties ain't hot as it used to be. The business plan ain't, I'm not really focusing on the business plan. A lot of the friends are dropping out of school, and I'm getting older now, and I gotta, if I leave school, where am I going? And I really had to think about this, like, where am I going to go if I leave school? Where am I going to go if this doesn't work out? You know, because I was in the moment. I was for the now.
You talked about how at one point you lost a lot of money, or you lost all your money. At that point, how did you pick yourself back up and start another successful business?
It took some time. I literally think it took some years, actually. But I think the reason why I lost all that money is because I was in a transition, because I wasn't feeling what I was doing anymore. I think the fact that I realized that I can't be outside till 4 a.m. passing out flyers, nor could I be out here just thinking I can make a living. I want to have a family. So I think when I was going through my transition is when I really found out that that's where I wanted to go, to find a purpose in life. And at the same time, keep the entrepreneurship spirit, and then also the things that I learned from my event planning. And that's pretty much how I do it. Right now, I look at the longevity. I definitely know from the fact that the route that I'm going is definitely is better than my previous one. So, I mean, you gotta grow. So I don't think any business should actually want to stay the same. When you're growing and you're becoming, again, your IQ is getting higher and you're meeting so many different people, there should be more layers and, you know, more different dynamics of what you're doing to make your business better and make yourself better.